इट्स नाउ टाइम टू रोल ऑन ओवर टू साज और आवाज। इसे पेश करेंगे डॉक्टर सतीश मिश्रा। आज डॉक्टर साहब के गेस्ट प्रिंसेस श्रेया भाटिया। मिस भाटिया इज रेगुलरली सीन ऑन ताल में ताल। टुडे शी विल शेयर दैट सेम ग्रेस ऑफ म्यूजिक हियर ऑन साज और आवाज।
नमस्कार, welcome to Women's World View, segment of Global Television Network. We are very proud today to have a youth from our community, Miss Shreya Bhatia, who is a sophomore in Thomas Jefferson High School. She has her own show and she is multi-talented. And you have seen her on several of these TV shows. And today, as you know, that we have focused on our youth, and we will talk about aspirations of our youth and their focus on our culture and heritage and how the globalization has made them different thinking and things like that. So especially as it relates to music, she has a special talent in music. So Shreya, welcome to the show.
Thank you so much for having me.
Yeah, so I would like you to tell our audience, very diverse audience, about yourself and what happened that made you so much interested in Bollywood type music.
I have kind of always been interested in Bollywood in my Indian culture. When I was younger, I would sit in the car and wherever we would go, my parents and I would play games like Antakshari and, you know, yeah, always be singing Bollywood songs. So I think that's where I got the first push that I wanted to go into singing, but, you know, specifically Indian classical Bollywood music.
So you are also interested in classical?
Yes.
And other type of instrumental music? Do you have any interest in instrumental music? Harmonium, tabla?
Right, I play the harmonium. Uh-huh. I have played the piano in the past, the violin. So yeah, I mean, I love music in all forms, and I have been training classically for the past.
You are still very young, yeah, not yet 16, going on to that.
Almost.
So it's really admirable that you are at a stage where many of us would never have even thought of being at this stage. And I also know that you have deep, very deep cultural roots, mm-hmm, imbibed, and you are very proud of our heritage and roots and culture and whatever it is. So what components of our culture and heritage have really made an impact in your life?
I think I was born here in America, uh-huh, but I visited India like 10, 12 times. And, you know, in comparison to many children who don't go to India that often. So I think going there and, you know, I have so much family there, we keep talking. So all of this, and of course, I'm always listening to Bollywood classical music. It keeps you very connected. I speak Hindi at home. Even with my friends, a lot of the times we speak Hindi with each other.
अरे बहुत अच्छा है, बहुत अच्छा हिंदी आती है और यहाँ पैदा हुई, यहाँ बड़ी हुई. So how that means 16 years you have been there 12 times, 13 times,
right?
Once every year almost.
Yeah.
And you picked up Hindi from India or from family or?
In the beginning, my parents would talk to me in Hindi. That's how I, you know, got the basics. But after that, I got so involved in music that I think a lot of my Hindi comes from listening to so much music. Like I'm sitting in the car and a song comes on and each word, I need to know what it means. So I ask my parents, and I think that's also where a lot of my Hindi comes from.
That's the way to go. Actually, that's how my son learned Hindi.
Yeah.
Watching Bollywood movies.
Yeah.
And that made an impact, even though that Hindi is not very pure.
Mm-hmm.
But it is still better than many people I have,
right,
talked to,
right,
you know, Bollywood type mixing English or,
right,
whatever you,
right,
want to call it. So if you have to pick a single item, one single item you want to focus on that has made you a better person, more globalized person, what would that be?
Actually, I think it would be education. The school that I go to, I go to a science and tech school, and it's I think it's definitely made me a more competitive person, and the school itself is diverse. So that's, you know, there's a lot of culture focus. all these clubs and everything. And so going to all of them and getting to learn more about other cultures as well has definitely made me a better person. And of course, I've met a lot of my friends there. So
you are saying that first thing is education.
Right.
You have to have a good education. You listen to that. You have to have a real good education to understand yourself, your culture, your roots, and become better in life. That's what you're saying.
Yeah.
Second thing is school does make a difference.
Yeah.
You're saying Thomas Jefferson has made an impact, science and tech school has made an impact in your thinking and broadening your thinking. And third thing is your family.
Yeah.
Family really has, I think family should be the first. Because without family's input and impact and parents' influence, you cannot get anywhere. This is what happened in my life.
Mm-hmm.
So that's very important. And so, one thing I want you to tell our second generation audience, where you think we are headed, people like you, second generation.
Right.
What is going to happen? Are they going to follow parents' path? Or they will have their own individuality and get more assimilated into the culture of this country, like melting pot?
I think this is actually something that I've discussed with my friends and family a lot. But I think our generation today, I mean, I myself have, I'm very connected to my roots and my culture, but I wish I knew more about India's history and, you know, so I wish that, I wonder how other people who might not have been to India that many times or who might not have that Bollywood music in their lives, how much they are connected. And so I kind of do worry that people who move here, people who live here, might lose their roots, and maybe the kids in India as well might try to become more, you know, westernized. So
last minute message to our audience.
Actually, my favorite singer is Shreya Ghoshal, as lots of people know. But and I met her, and she talked to me for about 20 minutes. And what she said really stuck in my mind. And so I would like to tell you, she said, no matter what your hobbies are, remember to always keep learning and remember that education is always first. And even though she is a huge singer now, she told me that she still focuses on learning. Everywhere that she can find knowledge, she goes for it. And stay grounded, stay happy, stay positive, and everything will go fine.
That's great. Education, learning, family atmosphere, and be happy. And now, we would like our audience to see one of your talent. And, you know, I have seen it, but our audience. So please, your chance.
मांगे मुझसे दिल नजराना हाय अल्लाह मुझे है कशिश कैसी कैसी है अदा सारा आलम मुझ पे फिदा मेरी ही निगाहों का सफे है नशा सारा आलम मुझ पे फिदा चोरी चोरी देखे मुझको हर दीवाना चुपके चुपके मांगे मुझसे दिल नजराना जी नजर आना हाय अल्लाह मुझ में है कशिश कैसी कैसी है अदा सारा आलम मुझ पे तेरा मेरी ही निगाहों का सब पे है नशा सारा आलम मुझ पे तेरा चोरी चोरी देखे मुझको हर दीवाना चुपके चुपके मांगे मुझसे
Shreya, it was a wonderful performance.
Thank you.
I want to thank you that you were able to find time to come to our show, Women and Globalization. And thanks a lot. And you all enjoy it and listen to what she said, education and learning. They're very important component and must be part of your life. Thank you very much. Namaskar.
Thank you.